You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, your host on this Wednesday, October the 22nd, 2014. I've just been given some news on this update on the shooting in Canada. The latest news is that one shooter is dead, one still believed at large in downtown Ottawa. So this is not a lone person. This is an actual conspiracy. Remains to be seen who is behind this. Looks like a terrorist attack. Report of additional shots fired near the Chateau Laurier Hotel east of Parliament Hill. Police are going door to door in the downtown core area. Downtown schools are in lockdown. All three main party leaders are reported to be safe. There you go. So interesting, as I was talking to Jakari Jackson at the bottom of the hour, why didn't security inside the Parliament building take care of this? You know, we saw the same thing happen at the White House. It just underscores the fact that the government can't protect you. They can't protect you in terms of violent attack. They can't protect you with your health either. We got a special report from Alex Jones. It's coming up in this hour, talking about what you need to do to protect yourself, because ultimately, we've seen that the government is not going to do anything to stop the spread of Ebola. They're not going to enact the kind of travel controls and quarantines that we believe should be enacted after an outbreak of this. It'd be very easily contained in that area. It's kind of like if somebody was sick with the plague in your neighborhood. What if they allowed that person to walk around freely in your neighborhood, but then they put all the other houses under some kind of martial law? Well, that essentially looks like what they want to do to us. Looks like they want to get this out of control. And of course, the question that many of us have is what's going to be coming down the pipeline with these drugs that they are rushing through? There's been a lot of talk about how they're going to rush vaccines and treatment drugs from Big Pharmaceutical, from the military who's partnered with them. They're going to rush those to market without doing safety and efficacy tests. We have a lot of concerns about drugs that have passed their safety and efficacy tests because when they manufacture them, they put a lot of preservatives in them, a lot of chemicals that are there to actually irritate your immune system. Those in and of themselves are very dangerous. I don't know that those are in there when they do the actual test, but are we going to be mandated to take some untested vaccine? And most of these vaccines are focusing on genetic manipulation. It's not like the vaccines that you've seen before. This is a new strain. It raises a lot of interesting questions. We're going to have Francis Boyle joining us in the third hour. He's going to talk about the bioweapons labs that are in Africa, where these outbreaks took place. He knows a great deal about this, having written two treaties about bioweapon research and control, as well as a book on that. So he's going to be joining us in the third hour. We're also going to be joined in this hour with Anthony Gucciardi, talking about some health victories and things, of course, that you can do to take control of your health, just as you need to protect yourself with your own firearms, because the government can't be there all the time to protect you with a policeman. They can't even protect the White House or the Canadian Parliament, as we're seeing. Now, there's also some breaking news. I saw this. This outbreak is fundamentally about open borders. And of course, the Obama administration has made it clear that they are going to open up a massive amount of amnesty after the election. They've put everything on hold until after the election. They will not do the kind of protocols and containment that we need to see with something as dangerous as Ebola, because it would push back against their open borders narrative. And we saw just yesterday that a spokesperson, Leon Rodriguez, the head of the Citizenship and Immigration Service, when asked about the immigration policy, the likelihood of executive action on immigration, he said he was put on a waiting list and he was eventually denied admission into Georgetown Law School. I want to take that analogy that he has and expand that a little bit further right after the break. And Anthony Gucciardi is going to be joining us. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They show pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it. Others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans. Made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it. Others don't.
Another major health threat, this one in Toledo, Ohio, where everybody in the entire city has been told not to drink the water.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency.
Did you know that the average person uses about 80 to 100 gallons of water at home every single day? If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.
We're here at a supermarket in Toledo. You can see the shelves empty where water once was.
To stay safe and healthy during a crisis, you must have access to safe, clean water. Water which will not be available at your local grocery store.
There's a mad dash on right now to stock up on supplies.
The ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system is a must-have for every modern, independently minded household. Protect your family's safety during an emergency. Go to InfoWarsStore.com today to purchase your ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system or call 1-888-253-3139.
The experts are clear. Sunlight, purified water, healthy non-GMO food, and having a good attitude is essential to a healthy immune system. But I go further with Super Nascent Iodine X2 from InfoWarsLife.com. 50% stronger than our original and revolutionary Nascent Iodine formula, coming from a deep earth crystal source that no other supplier has. Most other forms of iodine come from seaweed in areas plagued by Fukushima and other contaminants. Not our iodine. It comes from over 200 million year old crystal salt deposits and is tested and proven to be completely pure. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today. See the informational videos, read the information there compiled, and for a limited time, when you use promo code NOW at checkout, you get an additional 5% off the entire family of InfoWarsLife.com products. Secure your Survival Shield X2 today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll free 888-253-3139.
The Genesis Communications Radio Network proudly presents The Alex Jones Show, because there's a war on for your mind.
Welcome back to The Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight. I'll be joined here this segment with Anthony Gucciardi. But before we do, I wanted to go back to what I was saying in the last segment. You know, this is fundamentally this Ebola outbreak and the lack of response in most cases to it. Fundamentally comes down to open borders. The government is reluctant to do many things that they should because they don't want to push back against their open borders. And we know that it's coming on steroids after the election. The White House is punting on requests about the surge of immigrant IDs. They're ordering a tremendous number of immigrant IDs, as well as making other moves in terms of opening this up for people from other countries. Where the gentleman was Mr. Duncan, who got Ebola. In that community, they were speaking over 60 different languages. That was one of the problems that they were faced with. Now, when they asked Leon Rodriguez, who's the new head of Citizenship and Immigration Service, this is a subdivision of the Homeland Security, he said, when they were talking about immigration, he said he recalled how he was put on a waiting list and then eventually denied admission to Georgetown Law School. And that was where he was speaking that day. So he tried to persuade, he said, the school official to let him in, and he was told that he was lucky to even be on the waiting list. And so he said he thought that was a metaphor for immigration policy. You know what? I do too. Should he maybe have just admitted himself into Georgetown, regardless of whether he met the qualifications or whether or not they wanted him in the university or not? Should he have demanded free tuition? Well, we know that out-of-state tuition rates are given to illegal immigrants under the DREAM Act. As a matter, they can go to any state that they want to. No American citizen can do that. In many cases, they are, in fact, getting a free ride. So, yes, should you have any control over the people who basically immigrate into your country, who basically put themselves on your tab? I think we should. I think it's a very good analogy. I don't think that he has any right to force himself on Georgetown any more than someone who hasn't met the legal requirements, gone through the processes that legal immigrants go through, should be allowed to just self-import themselves into the country. Maybe if he'd gone to Georgetown, maybe he could have just said, you know what, I am now a student at Georgetown, and I demand a degree, and I demand that you waive all the requirements of the degree. Just give me my degree right now. Now, why not just do that? Listen, the government can't protect you. They won't protect you. We've seen that. They're going to leave the borders open. Anyone can bring this disease in. They don't have to go through an airport into the United States. They can go into a Central American country and then just easily walk in. So they won't protect you against it. But you know what? They can't even protect you against it. Here's Alex Jones's special report.
I'm Alex Jones. This is a breaking Ebola news update. In a moment, I'm going to break down some very important developments where the World Health Organization itself is now saying that the incubation period is not just 21 days, but can be up to 41 days. This was announced today, as it was also announced that they are releasing dozens and dozens of quarantine Americans who were around patient zero in Dallas only after 21 days of observation. And as more flights come into the United States from West Africa with people exhibiting signs of Ebola, it's clear that there is an attempt to whitewash and cover up exactly what's happening. But before we get into that, I want to just point out that InfoWars.com, the nightly news, and everything we do here is about us trying to find out what's really happening, not coming at you with a preset agenda or view like the controlled left or controlled right and the state-run media does. I want to know what's really happening with Ebola. I want to know if there are things out there that could protect this country and protect my three children, just as you do. We're teleprompter-free here, ladies and gentlemen. This is about really doing the analysis, really talking to a wide spectrum of experts and not trusting the system. And that's the good news. There are several polls out just this week. Public confidence in the CDC nosedives, CBS News reports, in a major poll. Another story, 64% believe America is out of control. And yes, ladies and gentlemen, America is getting more and more out of control. But the good news is when African leaders come out and say that this Ebola could be weaponized, people really aren't laughing anymore. In fact, we have an article on InfoWars.com that has a BBC video in it. Secret Project created weaponized Ebola in South Africa in the 1980s. To be used against blacks to reduce their population. So the alternative media is now becoming the dominant media, and we go out and source real facts and what's already admitted, and the system calls us conspiracy theorists and attacks us in publications every day, and it has no effect other than boosting our credibility. The arrogant, dying dinosaur media still thinks that demonizing us is effective. It's not, ladies and gentlemen.
Alex Jones may sound crazy, but still has 300 million YouTube, he had 300 million people that have watched him on YouTube, and that sort of fringe, arch-conservative, deeply, I think, racist strain is being tapped into at crazy profit by people in the media.
Well, it is, and I think the point you just made is the key thing, at crazy profit. These folks are getting paid to be racist.
Now shifting to the potentially bad news, the breaking info, CNN Today. UN staffer dies of Ebola, monitoring ends for 43 in Texas. 43 people who came in contact with Ebola patient Thomas Eric Duncan are now officially cleared after not demonstrating any symptoms during a 21-day monitoring period. Here's the problem. The UN on its own World Health Organization website and other mainline virology sites state the same fact, say that Ebola can easily live for 41 days in the body and 70 days in the semen in a man's testicles. So they are releasing people